Hi there, my name is Tammy, and I just want to help you out with your cranial nerves by using a memory aid. On the left-hand side, you'll notice I have a table that lists the cranial nerves, their function, and how we assess them. On the right side of the page, I'm going to start to put together the face of the cranial nerves. So cranial nerve number one is known as the olfactory. I've got one nose, and the first thing I notice about factories is the smell. So we test that using the sniff test. I'm going to bring down cranial nerve number two is our optic nerve, and I've got two eyes, so I'm going to put them in here. And how I test those is by visual acuity. It's another sensory nerve. I'm going to do the Snellen chart, test for near vision, and check peripheral vision. Cranial nerve number three, oculomotor, is a mixed nerve. I'm going to draw in the eyebrows using cranial nerve number three, and you'll notice that the middle part points towards the pupils, and this is where our perla comes from. Pupils equal and reactive to light and accommodation. Now 3, 4, and 6 work together. 4 is known as the trochlear. I like to think of it as to the other ear because it pulls our eyes in and down. And number 6, abducens. To abduct, to move away from, moves our eyeballs outward. Both of those are mixed but primarily motor nerves. Coming back to cranial nerve number 5, this is known as the trigeminal. It's the largest of the cranial nerves, tri meaning three. It has three branches. It's also a mixed nerve, and we test the sensory by using the cotton ball, and we will wisp it across the forehead to test the ophthalmic nerve. Then we will wisp it on the cheek to test the maxillary nerve, and then again on the chin to test the mandibular nerve. The motor test comes from having our patients clench their teeth, and we will test the masseter and the temporal nerves by having them clench teeth and resist opening. Cranial nerve number 7 is going to finish off our face. It's known as the facial nerve. Again, a mixed nerve, and what we do is we ask our patients to raise their eyebrows, show their teeth, puff out their cheeks, and do some of these activities against pressure, looking for symmetry. That brings us to cranial nerve number 8, known as the acoustic or the vestibular cochlear. Acoustic is sound and cochlear is the ear. Again, another mixed nerve, and we test this using the whisper test, the Rhine, and the Weber, looking for proprioception as well. Now cranial nerve number 9 I'm going to put in here as the uvula, and it's tested with cranial nerve number 10, usually at the same time. Number 9 is known as the glossopharyngeal, think pharynx, and number 10 is the vagus nerve. You're going to take your tongue depressor, ask your patient to say ah, and you should notice the midline rise of the uvula and the soft palate. The other test that goes with this is the gag reflex. Cranial nerve number 11. I think I've got two arms, and when they're standing beside me, they look like a number 11. So I'm going to draw in my shoulders here. And we test those by looking for symmetry on the muscles. We have our hands on their shoulders and ask them to raise them against resistance. And we also test the head rotation movement against resistance. That's the that's the accessory muscle. Accessory nerve. Cranial nerve number 12, last but not least, hypoglossal, think under the tongue. And what's happening here is with speech, if you notice that when you talk, the tip and the underside of your tongue touch your teeth and your soft palate, we're going to assess this by asking our patients to say light, tight, and dynamite. And you should notice a very sound, clear and distinct sound on the letters L, T, D, and N. And now you can carry on your learning with future textbooks.